I'd like to have a warm round of applause, please, for our first act, and that is Daniel.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for that warm reception. Today I shall talk about design and the design process and illustrate it through how I design a component. Normally people see a design product and gadget and ask, how did people do that? Well, I shall attempt to answer that question. So I was part of the former student team. Former student is a competition where engineering students from all over the world design and build a race car to compete against each other. And one of my tasks was to design the rear uprights. The rear uprights are a key suspension component to other components like the hubs, brake calipers, are sort of attached. So it's really important to get that right. So how do you start off? One, you need to know your constraints. Now, by this I mean how much time you got to do your design in, how much money, what's the manufacturing process available to you. And also, for designers like the rear uprights, it fits into the suspension. So you need to know what the suspension geometry is. Because that might have been designed by someone else. So once you know your suspension geometry, you can start to brainstorm your ideas. You can make a few sketches, so you do your brainstorming, and once you have a few ideas, you shot this down to a few you think are going to work. You model it in 3D computer aided drawing, so you can really see how they look. Then you select one idea to process further. So you refine it, you add all the details that are necessary, and once you've developed it to the point where it's going to be similar to your final design, you start to test it. So this is just simulating, so seeing how it would work in real life using software and computers. So how do you work when it's breaking? When the car's breaking. How do you work when the car's in situation? You want to see the stresses in it and see whether it'll fail or not. So if it doesn't fail, your simulation is good. That means you can refine your product a little bit further. Racing components needs to be as light as possible because you want to go faster than other guys, so yeah, that's pretty good. So once you know it's not going to fail, you start to optimize it. So you make it lighter, then you test again. You make it lighter, then you test again. So you do that till you're satisfied with the process. And then you can go along. So once you've reached your final solution, you can proceed to manufacture. But everyone can use these processes. So identify your constraints, brainstorming, shortlisting, design, testing, developing, testing, refining, and optimizing. Use all these processes yourself and make